Hello, internets, and welcome to this week's episode of Google Plus Developers Live. So we're going to take a break from the best practices episodes that we've been doing, and we're going to be showing you the quick starts. So this week we'll be doing the C# quick start on Windows. And the short version of what this does is it's going to create a web server built on top of ASP.NET, and it's going to host a front end that will render the sign-in button, sign in the user, and then pass authorization tokens to the server in order to make API calls server side. So if you want to get started with this, the launching off point is going to be developers.google.com/plus/quickstart/C#. So let's take a look at my screen and walk through the sample. So here you have the landing page for the C# sample. And inside of this set of instructions is going to be the first command is going to be for cloning the actual sources from our GitHub project page into your local machine. So what you would do is just copy this command, git clone github.com/google+/g+quickstart-c#.git. So let's run that command. So what it's doing is it's just copying the sources from GitHub into my local machine. So now in the folder that I've set up for my Git bash, I will now have the Google Plus Quick Start. So here's the Quick Start itself. Now what I will do is I'm just going to open up the solution inside of Visual Studio. So once the solution's opened, what I'm going to have to do is set up the client credentials before I'm going to be able to make API calls on behalf of the user. So what I'm going to have to do next then is set up an API project inside of the API's console. So the place that you start here is code.google.com/APIs/console. So here we have the API's console. For those of you who are unfamiliar with it, this is where you create all of the projects that use Google APIs. So if I want to create a project that uses the Google Plus APIs, for example, then this is where I would start. So let's create a new project. So when you create the project, the first thing you need to do is come up with a name for your project. So the name that you give your project is just for you. This is not going to be public-facing information. This is just information so that you know one of your projects from another. So I'll just create a project for this GDL. And so here's the project that's created. And after the project gets created, you then turn on the services that your project's going to consume. So because this project is only going to be using the Google Plus API, I just need to turn on the Google Plus API. So it's right in the middle, and it's sorted alphabetically for those of you who are hunting through. And the plus in Google Plus actually appears as a P in the alphabetical ordering. So after you've created your project and you've turned on the service for Google Plus, you now are ready to create your authorization credentials. So what I did there was I clicked this Create an OAuth2 Client ID button, the big blue one. And inside of here is going to be the branding information that will be facing your customers. So when you label this information, please take the time to ensure that the information is accurate and is consistent with the branding for your particular product. So because this is just a GDL quick start, I'm just going to have a less meaningful name. But this is fine for now. So I'm going to be creating a web application. And I'm going to be running it from localhost, port 4567, just as is set up inside of the tutorial. So the reason that I switched this also was because HTTP versus HTTPS matters. So when you set up these projects, pay extra careful attention to the port and the protocol that you're using, because it needs to match wherever you're going to be running this code. So I'll create that client ID. And after that's done, what will happen is there will be a client ID and a client secret. And so these are the credentials that Google uses to ensure that the people who are accessing the APIs are the right ones for that particular project. So make sure that you protect this information on your deployed applications. So here we have the project again. I'm going to open signin.ashx. And this will actually open the code behind. And so inside of the code behind is the settings. your client ID and your client secret. So these are the ones that you got from the API console. So here's the client ID, the client secret. And now, if we run the sample, you will see the application running. So here's the sign-in dialog. I click it. I'm presented then with this request for permission. So all of the services that are set up and included inside of the scopes will appear here for your users. So make sure that when you request scopes, that you request the right ones for what your users will be doing. So after you've done this, you accept because you trust this product. And then after you accept, the sample will run. So what happens when the sample runs is up top, we render some really minimal UI. And then we use the JavaScript client library in order to retrieve a user's profile. And then we perform a RESTful API call to the server endpoint, which was created. And then that will retrieve HTML for the people that are visible to this app. So there's a server-side call that's happening there. There's a client-side call that's happening there. And so once you've got this working, then you've seen the Google Plus client libraries running inside of your Google Plus application. And that's pretty much all there is to it for the Quick Start. Now, let's take a closer look at some of the things that are happening behind the scenes when this is done. So I'm going to put a breakpoint in here. And this breakpoint will cause the code to pause when we have retrieved the user's list of circled people. So let's see where the endpoint is for that. So here's the request path contains people. And so here you can see something that starts to look like a Google API call. So you have this people feed object. You've got PS is actually a plus service object. And then inside of the plus service object, all of the client APIs are encapsulated into methods and objects. So this is a real simple API call. Doing this does not require very much setup, very much work. And when you run it, the result that you get is going to be that object representing the list of people. So I'll just go back to my server again. We'll run the sample again. And here's that. So here's where that server has set up that people feed request. And after it's concluded with that fetch command, you'll have inside of this people feed an object that just represents something from that user's Google account. So this gives you a general idea of how to get started with Google Plus and the Google Plus client libraries in C#. And feel free to ask questions on our Google Plus developers page and the Google Plus developer community on Google Plus. And feel free to reach out to us directly on Google Plus if you would like to as well. So once you have all this set up, you're pretty much ready for C# development. But what if you wanted to use or create a client application? So this is sort of one of the problems that our client libraries team has been thinking of, and they recently announced a new version of the Google API libraries, and this is built on top of the PCL. And so when you use the new library, you can put your applications on Windows Phone, on Windows Desktop, and in the new Windows 8. So feel free to check out that new library, but there are a few quirks to it that I want to share with you before we move on. So I'll close this solution, and I'll open up. So I have another one. I have another solution that has been updated to the new client library. So when you set up these projects, it's basically the same setup that we had before. You want to add references for .NET OpenAuth, the Google APIs library, OAuth2, and then the Google APIs plus V1. So if you look inside of my project references, you can see where I've added these four. The next thing you need to do is you need to turn on the NuGet packages for all the BCL stuff, and also for the dependencies of the new client library. So the major dependency is the Microsoft HTTP client libraries. And so you want to make sure to include that. And then that should also pull in the other components. You also will need to pull in the async for .NET framework library and then the Newtonsoft JSON. We used to ship the sample with Newtonsoft JSON in it, but now that you can acquire these libraries very easily, get the latest ones using NuGet, It just makes sense to instead ship it without, and then have people who are playing with the API to just add it themselves. So that's pretty much it. Like, everything looks and works exactly the same. When I updated to this new client library inside of my test app, there were absolutely no changes that I had to make to my code. Everything just was using the same API footprint. So there were no major breaking changes, except you just now have to be able to import all of these libraries that are required for Microsoft HTTP. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and come back next week at the same time, 2:30 p.m. PST, to watch another episode of Google Plus Developers Live.